In this video segment, I'm going to show you the technique for remodeling projects in Chief Architect. I'm going to use a simple bath project to demonstrate. Let's review the steps, and then I'll go through them in the software. Your typical first step is to draw your as-built plan. You can either import that from our Room Planner app or draw it as a new plan in Chief Architect. You can also trace an existing floor plan if you're working on an older plan that a client has. Once you have that as-built created, you then will save that project file as a remodel plan. And that is the second step to develop that remodel plan into your new design. When you're finished with the remodel plan and you would like to overlay the as-built on top of the remodel plan, perhaps you want to show that to the client. Perhaps you need to show it as part of getting your permit set to show demo walls. You can do that in the 2D view. You can do it with a CAD mask. In Chief Architect X11, we allow you to use a reference display to the external as-built plan. And in X11, you can also display that in 3D and overlay it with your remodel and as-built plan together. So let's go ahead and open up a plan and go through these steps and discover how to do remodeling in Chief Architect. I have open an as-built bath. I'm not displaying the dimensions, but you can assume that I've gone through, measured everything that was important. Maybe you want to put in the fixtures, maybe you don't want to put in the fixtures. Once you have the important components of your as-built in place, you could then do a save as to your remodel project. If you know in advance which walls might be demoed, you could actually go in and draw a CAD layer over the top of those walls and show it as a demo. Let me show you how I might do that, and you can take a look. In my as-built plan, I'm going to show the walls that are going to be demoed, removed walls out of this plan. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a CAD rectangular polyline, and I'm going to come down here. First of all, I'm going to create a legend, and this is going to represent the line style that I use to create the demo walls. So I'm going to open it up. I'm going to make changes to it. I'm going to put an orange fill in it, and then I'm going to write the word demo walls off to the side. And then I'm going to use that same style of box and draw over the walls in the plan that will be removed. So the first step is I'm going to open up this CAD rectangular box, and I'm going to come in here and I'm going to change the line style to be a dashed line style. I'm going to change the color of it to be an orange color. And I'm also going to put a hatch pattern on here. We'll come down, select the strip style, and I'm going to change it to be an angle hatch, so I'll put in 45 degrees to angle that, and again I'm going to use the same color, and then we'll go ahead and close this dialog. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use some text, and I'm going to come down and I'm going to write the term demo walls. The CAD box and the term demo walls, I'm actually going to assign those on a layer because I don't want that to obscure my floor plan. And I'm going to create a layer for demo, and I'm also going to create a layer set for demo. And that way I can easily toggle those things on and off. And then I'll use this CAD object and I'm going to trace over the walls. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and select both the CAD box and the text, and I'm going to open those up and I'm going to put those on a new layer, and I'm going to, since I've selected dissimilar objects, both a CAD box and text, it says no change. You can still go in, press the define button, and I'm going to choose which layer those components go on. I've actually created a new layer and I've just called it demo. I'm going to go ahead and select that layer. That way I can easily toggle this on and off as I need to. Before I deselect these objects, you can see that they are blanked out. That layer is not currently turned on in my floor plan layer set. What I want to do is I want to create a new layer set that just shows those demo elements. So I'm going to go ahead and press the space bar, deselect these items, and I've created a layer set specifically for the floor plan demo. Let me change it to that layer set. It's going to turn that on. If you look at what is turned on in that layer set, you'll notice that the demo has been toggled on for that layer set. Let me go ahead and close this dialog. I now want to use this CAD box and trace over the different elements. Since this CAD box is already on the layer for the demo, you could select it, press the copy button on your keyboard, press paste, and then use that to trace over your walls. If you were to build an annotation set and have all of your CAD show up, you would then just be able to draw a CAD object. But I'm just going to show you the simple way where I'm going to draw a CAD object over one of the walls that's going to be demoed. And then I'm just going to repeat that process. I'm going to paste that CAD box back over into the plan. And I'm just going to snap onto the wall. Go ahead and pull it back. So a little bit of busy work to create these objects in here. Copy that, paste it, or the half wall for the water compartment. And then the last wall, let's go ahead and use the copy and paste this CAD box. I'm going to pull it into this wall over here. Those are all on a layer for demo. If I switch my layer set back to the floor plan, notice that you don't see them. So this is an easy way to make it easy to switch your layer sets, and if you're using annotation sets that will put your text and CAD and dimensions on a separate layer, you could create a saved plan view, which I've done for this video. And that makes it easy to change everything, and I can just simply toggle the floor plan and it will change my layer set and my annotations and my dimension defaults and a bunch of things. If you're interested in learning more about annotation sets and saved plan views, you can watch those in a separate video. But what we've done here is we've created a layer. We've assigned a text and a CAD object to that layer called demo. And now I can easily show the demo walls. And now the process, I'm ready to create my remodel plan. So I'm just going to do File, Save As. And I'm going to save my as-built plan as the remodel plan. I'm now working in the remodel plan, and this is where I'll go through and make the design choices that the client will eventually use and enjoy. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to skip ahead and show you the completed design, and then I'll show you how to overlay the 2D CAD that we've just created for the as-built, and I'm also going to show you how you can display that for the 3D view. Okay, well, I've finished the design. I'm pretty quick at this, apparently, and the client loves this new design. And if you want to show those demo walls that we just created, that layer still exists in this plan, and you can see where those demo walls were that we removed or extended out. And that's just controlled through that same layer set that we created, the demo layer that we created for the legend, and then using that same CAD mask on top, easily shows where those demo walls were located. And that's just a matter of showing it in the layer set. And again, I've kind of used a saved plan view to quickly show things on and off so you can hide that. Beginning in Chief Architect X11, we've allowed the reference display to reach out to an external file. Reference display you've typically used to display the floor above or the floor below on your current floor and superimpose it. The new reference display can reach out to an external file. Let me double click on the floor indicator in my menu, and let's open up the reference display options. Currently, my reference display is set up to be in the current plan, which is the red indicator, and it's on the automatic floor, and the reference display set is the layer set. I'm going to choose the as-built plan. So I'm going to browse out to the folder where I've saved my as-built plan. We'll select that plan. Notice that the as-built plan updates here. Floor, I'm going to use the same floor. And for the layer set, I'm going to change that. I've created a set just for the as-built shell that's only going to show the outline of the walls. You can really turn on anything you want, but I'm going to just show the display of the walls and the fixtures as well. Now I want that to be below the main display of the floor plan, so I'm going to move that down so the floor plan will display on top, and then the reference display from the as-built will be superimposed below that. Let's go ahead and close this dialog. And now you can see the as-built plan. I have that layer set to be a slight orange. I've turned the layers on to be dashed lines. And like I'd mentioned, you can turn all the things on and off that you want to display. You can toggle the reference display, F9 on your keyboard, and it will superimpose that just by turning that on and by turning it off. Now I'm going to step back for just a moment. I'm going to reopen the as-built plan that we were previously working on. In this as-built plan, I built a layer set specifically to show the as-built shell. And this is what it looks like. This is a layer set. When I changed my save plan view, it changed my layer set to this as-built shell. If you were to explore what I've done in this layer set, you'll notice that my walls are a hollow dashed orange line, as are my fixtures, my cabinets. All of those things are in this layer set. So those elements that are turned on, if I sort this, you can see what's turned on and what color I've used for this. It might be easier to sort this in this direction. So all of these things that were important to me that I wanted to display, I don't have everything turned on in here, such as footings, but things like our interior fixtures, I changed the color, set it to be orange. I changed the line style to be a dashed line style. That only applies to this set of layers, so when you switch your layer set back onto the floor plan set, it looks as your normal plan that you'd like to see, or if you have your kitchen and bath layer set turned on, then it has those layers turned on. So going in and creating a specific layer set for the as-built allows me to now superimpose that. I toggle over to the remodel plan to superimpose that, and it's not overwhelming in the design. That's a new feature that we've started implementing in version X11, and you can easily use that. We've also implemented it in a 3D view. Let's take a look. For the 3D view, I'm going to use the perspective floor overview camera. So this represents the new remodel project that we've created for the client. And now I want to superimpose the as-built in 3D. What I'm going to do initially is, since this is not yet built, I'm going to toggle this view on to the glasshouse view. Then, just like we did in the floor plan view, I'm going to go to the floor indicator and I'm going to double click on the floor indicator. And this is the same reference display interface that you see in your floor plan view. I'm going to come down, I'm going to browse out, and I'm going to grab that as-built plan that we previously used. It's already in my recently used list. Typically, it will use the same layer set, and you can choose between the standard rendering and the glasshouse rendering. Now you're going to notice in my background I have glasshouse rendering on the remodel, and you see dark thick lines around the edge surfaces. In the reference display you don't have that same dark edge line. In this case I'm going to go ahead and use the standard camera view, and then we'll toggle that on. So I'm now superimposing the as-built plan into the remodel plan that doesn't yet exist, and now you can see, maybe it's appropriate to show your client, you can rotate around and see the difference in what the design is going to look like. And you notice that we bumped this wall out maybe 4 feet, and this used to be space for the garage. The closet's now extended, and maybe this is something that will help the client better appreciate and see what the new space is going to look like. This can be toggled on and toggled off the same way you do in the plan view. I was pressing the F9 to toggle the reference display on and off. That tool you will also find in your edit menu on the side. You can toggle that on, toggle it off, and now you can superimpose that in your 3D view. Back in the plan view, same concept. You can toggle the reference display on and toggle it off. You can control what layers are being displayed. If you go back in to the reference display, you can actually edit the layer set for the as-built, and you can choose what you want to turn on and off. So if I wanted to turn those fixtures on and off, you could come in to the fixtures, easily come in here, toggle that layer off, and then you'll notice that the fixtures now disappeared. You could do the same thing for the tub platform and the cabinets directly through the remodel plan. So the reference display, again beginning in X11, allows you to reach out to your as-built plan or another plan. You may be using this to display option A, B, or C. Allows you to superimpose these elements either in your 2D view or in your 3D view, and allow you to help your clients or the building contractor visualize exactly what you're after.